Welcome, everybody, to the
I'm Fat Podcast.
Snacks are best saved for later.
With Jay Zawoski.
That man ate all our shrimp and two plastic lobsters.
And Rick Camp.
Out of the mist came a beast more stomach than man.
Welcome in to another edition of the I'm Fat Podcast, brought to you by our sponsors, Charlie the Bacon Guy, Mazda of Orland Park, and Frato's Culinary Kitchen. I am Rick Camp, alongside fellow fat Jay Zawoski. If this pod ends up anything like what's happened pre-show, for good and for bad, then you're in for one today. So make sure
you are strapped in. Well, freezing. Yes, indeed. It has been a exciting pre-show and an even more exciting show to happen, I suppose. Let's hope so. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you're following us on social media at I'm Fat Pod. That includes Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, Patreon. We've got our YouTube page. Make sure you're following our YouTube page, youtube.com/I'mFatPodcast. Thanks for everybody who tuned in to last week's live episode that we did kind of like randomly, like
haphazardly.
Let's just see what happens. And it worked out pretty well. So we'll see as things go. We'll probably try to do one or two of those a month. Well, every episode's on YouTube. Look for those to drop on Tuesdays when we have our normal release schedule. I know the last 2 weeks have been a little weird, but let's do it. This is great. What else? That's it. I think we got all the proppers out of the way, right? Oh, yeah. Fat phone. Leave us a message, 708-858-3314. Send us an email, imfatpod@gmail.com.
Wait, did you finally remember the phone number? Or did you move your paper that has the number on it?
I'm looking at the scroll on the bottom of our screen that
has
the number.
Oh, that's true.
I can see that. Yeah.
Because I was wait a minute. You didn't do your look to your left.
I will for the address and phone number for Mazda of Orland Park.
Good call.
And all the way. I just do it. It's more for confirmation than it is for me not knowing it. Like, if you ask me, I could probably tell you.
Yeah.
But on the show, I want to be certain that I'm getting it right.
Mm-hmm. What was it like being an extra on Touched by an Angel?
I am getting a bit of a...
Yeah.
The sun is coming through my... So I'm in my basement, and I have those, like, I don't know what you call them, like the glass block windows.
Yeah.
You know, and you can't see through them, but they look nice. And I can see, like, the full sun is right there. So I'm going to have some definite halo action to me. And sorry about that. If we weren't dicking around for the first 20 minutes, we were talking to each other. Sunlight for now, but hey, man, I'm here. I'm welcoming all the sunlight while I can. I have to say though, before we get to the
stuff,
weather is lovely. I'm not complaining about it,
right?
But it's I was in a car a lot yesterday, and it's really hard to get right.
Yes, it is.
Like, I'm going to wear a hoodie or I'm going to wear like a long sleeve shirt because it's cool out. But then I'm in the car and it's 95 degrees. And then you have I'm not turning the air on. It's 60 degrees out. It'd be stupid to turn the air on. So you're constantly battling the heat. And I have new jeans that are not properly broken in.
Yeah, so
that's a tough combo on me right now.
Yeah. You know what I do in that situation with the car? I turn the air on because comfort wins.
I know. I had passengers, unfortunately. So
pesky
anyway,
family.
Yeah. How's your week been? How's everything going?
Very busy. I'm
busy.
Yes.
Why?
Very busy. Well, to previously on the I'm Fat Podcast, a big thing last week was that I signed up for dating apps. So
the whole concept excites me.
Yeah, right. So as a result of being on said apps, I had my first date in 13 years.
Yes.
Yes. Which is awesome. There's stories that I can tell right now that I can tell, but we got to go before that first, because that's where
I was going to move my mic out of the way.
Yeah. Right. That's where the trauma happened. Because
what though?
No, I'm telling you, this is so because my friends know me so well. One of my best friends, Kara, she's like, all right,
She didn't get a bell. I don't know that name.
No, she has not been she's not bell worthy. I just haven't mentioned her very often, but she's like, okay, I know you. You don't have the right clothes for this date. She's like, so
accurate.
And she was 1,000% correct.
She knows about the polo.
Yes. Oh, yes. She does.
And I like to imagine polo. Like you in the Batcave, you go down, you hit the button. It like comes up in this thing.
Yes. It's got the smoke and whatever. Yes.
Right. The polo.
So she was like, okay, well, tell me, you know, if, because this was before date was scheduled. She's like, tell me when it's going to happen and we'll try and find a time to go out. Like she was going to go with me and basically hold my hand through buying clothes. Well, thankfully, date ended up being this week. So we had to do this all via text.
Oh,
which was like, she's thorough and she wants the best for me. And like, it's not like she did anything wrong by any stretch of the imagination. However, me trying on clothes and then being like, and then it being, okay, let's try on these types of jeans. Okay, cool. We've settled on jeans, which took a hot minute anyway. Then it's okay. Here's these 5 shirts we can try. And also then let's try and find shoes. And the thing for normies when dealing with fats is not realizing where the thresholds are for when things become more difficult to find. And I am on the more difficult side of said thresholds. Mm-hmm. So like 3X versus 2X makes a world of difference in terms of availability.
Yes.
I'm on the 3X side of that right now.
Like you can't walk into a Target and find a 3X.
No. I used to rely on Old Navy, and I can't go to Old Navy.
Yeah. You're talking department stores at this point.
Yes. And shoe wise, I'm a size 12, which is very normal. However, it's the width. Mm-hmm. You can find wide shoes. You can't find 4E width, which is essentially the 3X of shoes. So
that's true.
So Kara being like, well, why don't you try this? Or why don't you look at this brand or this or this? Like, so I tried some Hey Dudes. You know what my foot is? Too wide for Hey Dudes.
That's significant. Because I've got room in my dudes.
Phrasing.
Wow.
Yeah.
That surprises me.
Yes. So I wasn't able to get new shoes, but I was able to get a new, like a nice looking pair of jeans and an adult looking Henley.
The shirt you wore, you sent me a picture just now.
Yeah.
Looks good. That shirt you wore. I can't share the picture because we are keeping the identity of said person. But if you want to, maybe we can crop it and send the cropped photo out on the video for YouTube later.
Sure.
It's shirt looks good on you. Picture of you. Good smile. So the shopping went well. That's good. Now
you're trying on all this stuff. So then you have to like take all the stuff off and then you're wearing jeans the entire time. So you're getting hot.
Oh yeah. You're sweating your balls off. Yeah.
I was, and it's like, I kind of felt bad. Cause it's like, then these clothes that I'm not going to end up getting, I was kind of sweaty while I was wearing. And it's just like,
don't feel bad though, because everyone has tried them on is also your size. So
that's true.
You took home some DNA with you as well. Yeah. Don't worry about it. Yeah.
Yo. But so yeah, that was 100% a thing. And of course, while it's all going on, I am beyond inside my head about it. That is just something that is like, especially the having to explain how the sizing and why fats hate it all so much part was like, I felt that was very noteworthy and to bring up for the podcast because we've all been there.
Where did you go?
Pennies.
Oh,
I went to Penny. Pennies is Pennies. I think their big and tall section, at least the ones by me, infinitely better than Kohl's. One by me is very disappointing.
The Michael Strahan jacket that I'm going to wear to every wedding from now to the end of time.
And they have the Shaq brand that I've talked about before. Like they've got some stuff for fats. So I appreciate them for that. But I also I checked Kohl's. I checked, I went to DSW. I went to Dick's. I went so many goddamn places. I was like, I dislike clothes. However, you know what's worse? At least I know right now for me, not wearing clothes. Yeah. So I got to find clothes.
Yeah.
But I was able to get an outfit for this date.
That's good.
It's all downhill from here.
Nah. I mean, it'll get more casual as you go too. Yeah. Like, you know, you're never going to be quite as formal. Like, let's say you go to a movie next time or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to have to like
no.
do it up. You know, I think it's probably a good idea for you anyway.
Oh yeah, exactly.
It's overdue. And it was for me too. Yes. Like, I'll tell you, like the job at BBM for the short time I had it, I probably got more clothes in those 4 months or 5 months than I did in like the 10 years prior.
Yeah.
Like, it's just like, God, I can't wear the same three shirts every day. I'm going to look like an idiot.
Right. And then you're wearing three shirts every day, which is tough anyway.
Shut up. You know what I mean, you ass. Every week, whatever. Shut up.
Hey, I've done it.
And but the good news about the score job is there have been times in our lives we've needed fancy shoes, but we never had to wear them to work.
Yes, so exactly.
We've got some. I don't know where they are. I'll have to find them in time for Tony's wedding.
They have plenty of dust.
And the other good news, though, is now the style is really casual shoes with suits. So, like, you can wear, like, black, almost like gym shoes.
Dude, I wish I could fit into the shoes that all I want in life. And I know this is pretty basic now as that style's gotten more popular.
Yeah.
I just want some Jordan Concord 11s.
Nikes are really narrow.
They are. That's the thing. I'll never be able to wear them ever because they don't make them for me. And honestly, who knows if it even still looks good if it were made for me.
Try the brand Sperry. It's like Perry with an S before it.
Yep.
Sperry.
Yep.
I got those and you'll see them at Tony's wedding. Mm-hmm. I got those like, they were part of a Stitch Fix. Remember, I was doing Stitch Fix for a while, and they said, I'm like, oh, these are kind of cool. Mm-hmm. These work. And I decided to keep them and never really wore them until I started going on this run of weddings.
Yeah.
And now they're my dress shoes. They're navy blue because my coat's navy blue. So it's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
So there's options out there. But I mean, don't sweat it because, as we said last week, like, this person is not going to continue to date you based on your wardrobe. Right. Like,
especially me.
Well, but no, I mean, it's you did the right thing. You went out and got haircut, and I could tell you got a haircut, got shaved, got lined up real nice. And like, that's the sort of stuff you want to do on a first date. I'm sure she did the same. Mm. Right. Or found one of her nice. She's probably got more nice outfits than us.
Oh, yeah.
She's a normal person.
Right.
you know, and, you know, that's great. But I'm really happy for you. I'm glad it went well. Yes. Well, I know you're going to get to it.
Yeah.
The fact that you're talking about it and not upset makes me think it went pretty well.
It went very well.
Good.
Went to Putt Shack in Oak Brook, which is like the kind of like high tech mini golf with like bar restaurant type feel to it too.
Oh, I never heard. Oh, I thought you went to like, so it's like I was thinking when you, a Top Golf. Is it like Top Golf?
No. It's mini golf. So there's 4 9-hole courses. There's a little chip in every ball. So you don't have to keep score. It's like, it keeps track of who is next and what your score is. And you get points for like how many strokes you need to get the ball in for specificity's sake, but also like if you shoot like a certain direction, then maybe you'll get more points than shooting a different direction, another direction, that type of thing. It's really cool.
What's the same technology as Top Golf?
Yeah. Yeah, cool. Exactly. Cool. Same type of thing. And then, so like when I booked it, it's like, you can book a time for that and then book a time for a table for dinner right afterwards. So I did that. And
how was the food?
Food was pretty good. I had I forget if it was considered like an Italian flatbread type thing. It was like pepperoni, sausage, giardiniera. I wouldn't say it was fantastic, but it was like, it was really solid.
Yeah.
And it was very on brand.
I appreciate that you were like, well, I'm not going to do the bucket of chicken tenders on the first date, but I'm also not going to just get a salad by any means.
Oh,
the flatbread is a perfect fat guy first date meal.
Oh,
because you're still getting like the buffalo chicken or the pepperoni and sausage or whatever, but it's like, but it's a flatbread, so it's healthy.
Oh, now I will say one thing I definitely have to improve on. Partially because I was actually like really engaged in the conversation, didn't pay attention to the fact that I housed my food before she was done with like half of hers.
Yeah.
Well, there's that. Where then I looked up and I was like, well, shit.
That's so good. So, yeah. But it's, that's fine.
Yeah.
It's but you, but you're putting yourself out there. Yeah. I love it.
But still, like the place in general, really cool vibe to it.
I gotta check that out.
Dude, it's pretty awesome. Yeah, earlier in the
night. Yeah, probably like early in the day, right?
Yeah, earlier in the day. For 9 holes, it's like $14 on the thing. So not the cheapest thing in the world, but
for 9?
For 9. Yeah.
Whatever.
It was, I think it took us, because there was like a few, we had to do a little bit of waiting between holes, but like, because of the atmosphere, like it feels more like a date spot to me.
Cool.
Maybe it's because of the context that I went there, but still. So yeah, if you're looking for like a fun night, like that's a good option.
That sounds fun. Yeah. That's great. Yeah. And perfect. What day was it?
Thursday.
That was a nice day, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or no, that was the day it was raining.
Oh,
but
right.
Yeah. So this was indoor. So this is,
it's indoor.
Yeah. It's indoor. So it's like Oakbrook Mall.
Okay, cool. So that's outdoor. That's why I was confused.
Oh, yeah, good point. Don't mind me, dude. I've gotten so little sleep this like last four or five
days. It is
not like that.
Oh, okay.
But I've been doing a lot of stuff. So, but yeah, so highly recommend Putt Shack. Give it a spin. If you're looking for something different to do for a day out, the food looks really good, seeing like what other people got. Intriguing options. So if I go there again, I'll have something different just to give it another spin.
This is my question now. What did she get?
Some sort of like Asian salad-y thing. I didn't hold it against her.
I might have.
Yeah. Well, you know.
Was there any sort of cheese or meat in it?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah. If things keep going the way they feel like they are at the moment, there may have to be some conversations that have to be had on the podcast. But we're not going to go there. We are not going to go there yet.
We need to talk. You will not be eating salad in my presence ever. It is offensive to me and my people. I am trying to maintain a brand here and an image.
Right.
I have curated my personality as a fat for a long time.
Yes.
You 36 years, me 44, and you will not interfere with my brand. If it's going to be a salad, it has to start with taco. No, it's good. It's good. It's good. I'm really happy for you. That's great.
Thank you.
I'm glad it went well. Yes. Now you have to find another outfit. I think you got to do it one more time. The jeans you can rewear. That's fine.
Yeah.
You know.
Thing is, man, clothes are expensive.
Yes. They are.
Especially for fats.
I want to say, though, we had a very nice month on Patreon. Thank you, everyone, for that. And I am, after the show, sending you your Patreon money.
Oh,
so
thank you.
There's an outfit in there for you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
So, cool. Yes. Thank you, everybody, for chipping in on the Patreon. If you want to chip into Rick's dating fund, patreon.com/IFATPod. I'm telling you, it helps,
dude. I'm telling you, like, even like I have no qualms talking about it, but it's like in the midst of talking about it, I'm like, this feels so weird and so foreign.
Oh, but it's exciting though.
Oh, absolutely.
It's good. I'm very, and I like, yes, like last week we were kind of joking like, oh, it's all for the content, and yes, that is a fun part of it, but
100%
as it one is of my best friends, I'm very happy. Yeah. Like, I'm just thrilled for you.
Thank you.
And I can see in your face that you're feeling good about it.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. It's one of those. This sounds like corny, and I hate like making it kind of serious for a moment, but it's like, sometimes you don't realize like how much you were in a funk or how deep the funk was until you start the ascent out of it.
Yes.
And I was in even a worse place than I thought I was.
Well, and I will say that I am very impressed by how you've handled all the shit you've been through recently. Mm-hmm. Like,
thank you.
So it's impressive. Like, I would have been like, well, I live in a sleeping bag now. Please occasionally dump Cheetos in here and I'll stick my thumbs up out and we'll let you know I'm okay. You know,
by the way, did you see that statue this week? The Cheeto statue?
Yes, I did. I put it on the MFAT podcast Instagram. It is literally a sculpture of fingers like this. If you're watching on YouTube, it's a little more helpful. Yeah. Holding a giant Cheeto. And this thing's got to be what, like 15 feet tall?
Yeah, it's definitely a puffy Cheeto.
It's a puff Cheeto. And the fingers are all, you know, orange
dusty.
But the rest of the fingers are gray. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
All right, well, that leads me nicely. I tried a new Cheeto this week.
Oh, okay.
Did we talk about the Bolitas on the show before? So these are...
I don't think so.
They're Cheetos balls, like cheese balls. Okay. You know, like the Planters. Planters has them too.
Yeah, the things that take up like half the store that are on an end cap at like Walmart or something in the South.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
So these are Cheetos Bolitas. Mm-hmm. Got them at... Where were we? I forget where we were. Wherever we were, we got them and they were good. Hope got them. That's why I don't know where she was.
Okay.
But they're chili and cheese. And these are big in like... South America, wherever. They're not typically sold in America.
Oh, okay.
But now they're here. And similar, I got to say, the texture of these things was not what I was expecting. I was thinking it was just going to be another cheese ball. It was closer to a Cheetos puff, but a little bit crunchier with a really good flavor. And like, I started eating them, like, these are good. And I was like, just addictively eating them. And then Hope started having, she's like, these are really good. And then Addie came down, she's like, these are really good. And they were gone. The three of us, like, we polished off the whole bag in like 10 minutes. So they were great. So look for those.
Nice.
Also, did your mail arrive?
Oh my god, it did. It's sitting right here. I haven't even tried it. Do you want to grab it?
No, let's save it for next week. We got
true. We got a lot today.
The Twix pods came from Australia. We will hold our review until next week, but look forward to it.
Yeah.
I'm glad they arrived to you. In a Dr. Squatch box?
Yes. I saw that. I was like, that is about as on-brand as it gets.
I hope they don't smell like pine tar or Twix now. That would not be great.
That would not be a great flavor.
But I wrapped them up pretty good, so they should be pretty good. But we'll review the Twix pods next week.
Nice.
But yeah, the Cheetos Bolitas chili and cheese are excellent. If you see those in your store, grab them. They're amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, and speaking of malls, yesterday... I questioned my life choices a little bit.
Okay.
I texted you from this place and I said, Rick, I'm in Mount Prospect.
Yes.
At a Disney pin trading party.
Yeah. You put some words together that I never, like, a lot of times I'll say there's no bad words there. There's lots of bad.
There are
words
lots. There. Yeah. So if you don't know, and I never knew about this until our friends, Brian and Sarah, went to Disney, and then we went, and Addie participated in this too. These enamel pins of like different Disney characters and like situations, movies, whatever, is become this whole like culture of pin trading, and people carry around like little folios with all their pins. And when you're in Disney World, you say, "Hey, I see you have pins on. Do you want to look at my book?" And you trade, and it's beautiful. It's a really a nice thing. Mm-hmm. And the stores in Disney World and Disneyland have like their own little pin boards, and you can trade up to two. So it's just this whole little lifestyle. So our friend Sarah set this thing up where she found like a Facebook group that was doing it. And dude, you want to talk about Disney adults? These were some Disney adults.
I was going to say, Jay, you will not be shocked to know this. I knew about said culture.
I know you did. I know you did for sure.
Yeah.
But I was like, this is a lot. This is kind of overwhelming, but this is really cool. Everyone was super nice to Addie and her friend Tegan. Everybody was super cool. They got a bunch of pins they liked. They're super into this thing. It is a nice hobby that is not dangerous. They're not like drinking or smoking or hanging out at parks and making out with boys or girls or whatever. They're just trading pins. I love it. All for it. The beauty part of this is this party was at Mr. Beef and Pizza in Mount Prospect.
Ooh, okay.
Yes. So Addie got there a bit overwhelmed because a lot of people, and she was clearly like a novice in this room full of pros.
Sure.
But then she's like, I'm hungry. I could tell she needed to eat. So I'm like, we're here. we're doing it up.
Yeah.
I got the beef with mozz. Hope got a big slice. Mm-hmm. Addie got chicken parmesan sandwich. We got onion rings, mozzarella sticks, and fries. Addie got an Oreo cookies and cream shake.
Nice.
Like we, so all that, okay,
mm-hmm.
$44.
Really?
Yes, for all that.
That's pretty good.
I'm talking about a slice big enough to feed you, you or me, like a meal.
Okay.
Big sack of onion rings, mm-hmm. big sack of fries,
mm-hmm.
and I think it was like 8 mozzarella sticks.
Okay.
And a shake. It was really good. Here's what I'll say.
Okay.
None of the things I had are game-changing in any way, shape, or form. However, everything they had was really good.
The meal was better than the sum of its parts.
Well, I wouldn't even say that. Like, it's better than that, but like, mm-hmm. it's not the best beef or the best fries or the right. best pizza. All of it is really solid, and the menu mm-hmm. is huge. And the thing that I looked the best, I had a bite of it, was Addie's chicken parm.
Yeah,
it was like 3 nice chicken strips with a slice of mozzarella and marinara poured over it, and a nice toasted like brioche bun.
Oh yeah,
that looked fantastic. And then Brian got a Polish.
Mm-hmm.
Sarah got a gyro. Everybody was really happy with the food. Did need the Woodfield Mall facilities a couple times.
Yeah, how'd that go for you?
The JCPenney one was better than the mall one, where I walked into the mall stall and I'm like, nope, not going in there.
The mall stall. Yeah.
Yeah, it was not good. But you know, it was I had a lot of really greasy food.
Yeah.
But I justified it because I had an apple for breakfast.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we went to the farmer's market, and the taco truck wasn't there. So I'm eating an apple, and this lady, and I was like, oh, look at you having a healthy breakfast. I'm like, taco truck didn't show up. Like, I had full intentions of having 4 breakfast tacos, but it didn't show. So I'll have a honey crisp and just do it up for lunch. But that was great. But then my beef about Woodfield Mall, mm-hmm. and maybe I'm wrong because I don't get there very often. This is the biggest mall in the state, I believe. I did not see a Mrs. Fields / Nestle Toll House store. How is this possible in a mall this big?
Yeah.
How is it possible that I did not see either of those places? I was very upset.
Also, I scratched my nose and you didn't ask me what my beef was.
Hey.
Yeah.
Triggered. I was very upset.
Back for these compliments at some
point. Because a mall... Part of the perks of going to the mall is going to the cookie place.
Yes.
That's a highlight. And I usually go with the M&M sugar cookie.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll be like, I'll have one M&M sugar cookie, please. Like, if you get 15, you get the 16th free. What a deal. Let's do it.
Twist my arm.
Yeah. It's not 15. It's like, if you get 3, you get the 4th one free.
Yep.
Like, well, okay. That sounds like a good bargain.
I may have done that at Ogilvy more times than I'd like to admit. Who's
to say? Is there a Mrs. Fields or something in there?
Oh yeah.
Oh, that's dangerous.
Yeah. When I was taking the train all the time, I know that's, I wasn't that bad, but I mean, like it was, I was like, I'm doing this more than I should. And that's me saying that.
No, I get that.
Yeah.
I get that. All right. I want to give, I know you have some more stuff too, but I don't have a ton. So I'm just going to, and they all kind of lead into each other.
Oh, nice.
So speaking of beef,
mm-hmm.
today, I was driving around thinking about what to get for lunch because Hope was out. I was home alone and about a half hour before the Bears game. Like, I have nothing to eat here. So head out. I was going to go to Pop's, mm-hmm. you know, get some hot dogs and fries. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to go to Buona. Went to Buona, got the buffalo chicken sandwich and the fries. I don't think, and maybe it's because you don't have one very handy near you. Mm-hmm. Buona does not get enough credit in terms of its consistency and its service. And its overall quality of food, Buona is damn good.
I have one. I think it's like 15 minutes away, maybe. Yeah. But I've never gotten anything but the beef.
Yeah. And the beef's good. It's not earth shattering. It's not life changing. It's not the best beef in the world. It's
a really solid beef.
Yes. But like the rest of the menu,
mm-hmm.
like they have little individual pizzas. The burgers there are really good. All the ingredients are super high quality. The fries are great. They've got Ghirardelli milkshakes and brownies. Like, it is just a really high quality place with great service. It's affordable. They've got a good rewards program. Like, so you can like rack up points as you go. Mm-hmm. And then it actually like eventually adds up to stuff you can spend.
Yeah.
So I just want to give Buona props for being a place that it's one of those places where when we can't decide what we want, it's a place where all like, why don't we just do Buona? Yeah. And then we're all going to be satisfied.
Nice.
And it's great. So I just want to make sure that again, it's not the best of anything.
No,
but it is the whole is better than the sum of its parts. Is that the right statement?
Yeah.
Or the sum is better than the whole. Yeah. Yeah. The whole is better than the sum. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It is just a really good place. Always clean. Mm-hmm. Always really nice service. Like they communicate. The drive-thrus go fast. More places should run like Buona.
Yeah.
And I just want to give them props. So
okay. While we're on the rewards program thing, made me think of this, even though this is actually just a deal. I forget. Last week, did I mention Jersey Mike's?
Yes.
Okay. So okay, cool. The twos did the Giants sandwich thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. I don't know about that. No.
So
you mentioned how you were going so often because
it's right there.
Yeah.
Tuesdays and Thursdays, Giants are $10.
Oh.
Yeah, because like the sandwich I normally get, like I'll get the 13, is like I think for the regular it's like $9.40.
Oh yeah. So, even the smaller ones are like $7.99. Like the
yeah. So to get twice as much for $10. Yes. And then I'm more likely to try to do like the I did the Philly because I'm like, you know, their hot sandwiches tend to not have quite as much meat overall as the cold subs. So if you're able to get twice as much for not much more money, then you're killing two birds with one stone there.
Good thinking. And for a normal person, that's two meals.
Yes.
I should keep that in mind. I'm going, my parents love Jersey Mike's.
Yeah.
And that would feed my mom for a week.
Yeah. So Tuesdays and Thursdays. Those are the days you get your $10 Giants.
All right. Good to know. I will keep that in mind. And you should keep in mind, if you're in the market for a new car, Mazda of Orland Park. Go to MazdaOfOrlandPark.com as I look over at my sign. See? 708-444-3200. Ask for Eric Vates. That's with the V. Eric Vates. 8910 West 159th Street in Orland Park. The showroom, beautiful. The service is wonderful. I'm going to go when I get back from Denver. I'm going to Denver next week. So the following week, I'll be back for an oil change at Mazda of Orland Park. And I've been driving the CX-5 since 2015. And now I just got the 2022 CX-30 back a few months ago. And I love driving them. I love driving them both. I drove the 5 for the first time in a while.
Oh, yeah?
I had to do some chores and we had to go get some. We did had the solo stove out with Brian and Sarah last night. Mm-hmm. And had to go to, I call it Woody Wooderson. There's this old man who lives in Chicago Heights that just chops up wood and puts it outside his house. You put money in his little mailbox and take all the wood you need.
Oh, that's cool.
So I went to Woody Wooderson's and got some wood for last night and filled up the trunk of the CX-5. It was great. Love both cars. I will be a Mazda customer for life, not only because the cars have been so great, but because the service at Mazda of Orland Park is second to none and the buying experience is wonderful. I get nervous about this stuff and I felt so at ease and I trusted them and I was never misled. I have never seen like a surprise on my bill. Everything has been so smooth and they make it such an easy process from start to finish. And even once you have paid off the car, they still care. They still take care of you. They still treat you like a first time customer. So go visit them. MazdaOfOrlandPark.com.
Okay. So today I'm very sore.
Yeah.
Not from that.
sorry.
Right. Let's be realistic here. no matter how much better things are going, it's still me. So I forget what day it was. It actually might have been earlier in the day on Thursday or it was on Wednesday. Might as well get the bell ready again because I get this text from Marty. It's like, hey, it's homecoming this weekend at NIU. Do you want to do alumni band? Sign up was weeks, months ago. And I generally haven't. I haven't been back since for homecoming to do alumni band since 2010.
Oh, and, wow.
Oh, yeah. And he's like, so then I think he was talking about it with our buddy Bobby. And they basically were like, there's a way for you to do it. You just have to maybe not check in as yourself. That would be a way to do it because someone dropped out last minute. And Bobby was like, I can get you an instrument to be able to play. Because, you know, I don't have a sousaphone laying around.
Yeah, here. Just like, check your pockets. Exactly. Yeah, no, I don't have one.
So, so it was like a last minute decision. I went to NIU homecoming on Saturday, and they just got their, it was not a good football game. They played Toledo. I hate Toledo, and Toledo played very well.
You.
Yeah.
Goodbye, Toledo.
So, goodbye. Yeah. Okay. So I, so Saturday, for one thing, we have to rehearsal at 8 a.m.
I'm out.
Not great. 8 to 10:30.
Yeah.
Do the rehearsal. But I have not touched an instrument in 12 years. So first thing I do is I put it on and I'm like, this doesn't fit the same way it used to. A couple of us are like, they making these things smaller now? What are we doing here? Because, yeah, last time I wore one of those was probably a good 70 pounds ago, would be my guess. So I had to get that, to get used to that. And then also be like, how do I play this goddamn thing again?
True.
And also try and sound respectable enough. I know most other people, like a lot of people, like, whatever. But, you know, because I'm stubborn, I'm like, no, I played this and I was good. So I need to be good. That's how my brain works. I ended up settling, which is fine. But
did what rehearse- does Layla always say though? Layla, this always stuck with me. Layla Rahimi said, don't let perfect be the enemy of good.
Yes.
That has stuck in my head. That is one of the wiser things I've heard. I know it's not hers, but.
Right. But that is, yeah.
Something I need to hear sometimes.
Yes. So I doing marching for the first time in a while.
Oh yeah.
Like, a lot of physical activity for me, especially by my standards, was definitely up there. So afterwards, because this is what the alumni do, while the regular people, the students, actually have to be responsible. Okay, rehearsal ends at 10:30. We didn't have to be anywhere till like 1 something. So
happened.
Drinking happened. Where? No, where do you think drinking happened?
Oh God! What's the place in DeKalb?
Not Fatty's.
Oh, I give up.
That's Pizza Pros, because you're nice. Able to get cheese nuggets.
Yes, of course.
Cheese nuggets were consumed. Who's to say? But maybe between Marty, Bobby, and I, we went through 3 pitchers of beer. That could have happened.
Maybe.
And then, you know, as we kind of like went through the different areas for tailgating and stuff, possibility we found a few more beers.
Oh, just laying there. I mean,
yeah, I mean, they were just there.
You don't want them to go to waste.
That'd right. They looked lonely.
Yeah.
So you have to rescue the beers. So
brave of you.
Yes. So we were ready for pregame. So, do that. Yeah. And then while everybody else was like doing the, all the stuff in the middle of the game, like the stuff in the stands and whatever, we're like, now we're here for pregame and halftime, and we're just going to keep drinking and talking to people during the game. So, like, it was really a blast. Like, we're in an odd age group where most people that do, at least that I've noticed for Northern, is very recent alums, old alums. But yeah, for us, where we're in that, like, more than 5 years, less than 20 type thing, there's not a whole lot of, that was a pretty narrow, there weren't, it was like, what, maybe a handful of us total. Okay.
So you ended up not doing it?
I did do it.
Oh, okay.
We just basically selectively participated.
Okay.
Did we want to go do a bunch of marching in a parade formation for like an hour before the game? No. We weren't getting anything out of that. So we went around and drank instead. But like kind of knocked off some of the rust in terms of playing, in terms of reading music. I hadn't had to read music in like 10 years. So I actually have one piece that got copied wrong, so the music is actually like way bigger than it should have been. It didn't fit in the flip folder. So like the old from NIU pregame, for those that can read music and you're watching the YouTube, that's a very small niche.
Yeah.
But there's the old Hail to the Huskies that we play in pregame. But it felt good, and it was also just like, you know, for me, we know how I am with stuff with myself. I know I was really good at that. So being able to like do one of those things, and mind you, I sucked, but you know, like just getting to do it again. And like, you know, it felt good. It was good to do it. However, I, afterwards get home. I'm very sore.
Oh, like, I bet.
The shoulders, my shoulders are trashed right now. Hadn't done that. You know, like the indentation we always said in college, it felt like your shoulder was like going straight across and then the indentation where the instrument was, and then it keeps going straight across. So my shoulders, my neck, not good. Mm. And I violated one of my own rules.
Uh-oh.
There's no gold bond in the house.
Oh my God, Rick.
And by the time I got home, I was way too lazy to go back out and get gold bond. So I had a blast. It was great to see people. But when I got home, I was struggling.
Yeah, I bet.
So, and then especially I had to get up early today, Sunday, when we're recording, because I'm working my one shift a week for BetQL. Well, it's Chicago Marathon Day, which means driving is essentially a no-go to the loop. So I took the train, but the train I had to take was so early just to make sure I got to work on time. That part was insane. I did have to cut through the runners at one point. And let me tell you, there was a guy, there was a guy in his element who damn near had a concussion because he would have run straight into me.
Oh my God.
And he was like a tiny dude. So like, I was doing my best to like not break a not have anybody have to break stride, because like, I'm trying to be respectful of what they're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah. This guy almost got like forearm shivered just like, cause I would have just done one of those out of, you know, just instinctively. And I got to work and that was fine. Afterwards, I found a phenomenon for myself.
Okay.
I found the way that I can walk faster than normies.
And you Uber?
No, they have to have run a marathon first.
Ah, there you go. You're laughing. I'm like, what's wrong with you?
Yeah.
Mr. Foil Blanket.
Yeah. Yeah, your legs are like atrophying right now.
Get over it.
Yeah, right? So I'm like, God, just scoot over. Go to the right so I can walk past you. You slows.
There you go. Good job. You're passing Kenyans as you're walking to the train. My cousin Meg, by the way, my goddaughter, Meg, ran the marathon. She's, I think she's a sophomore or junior at Iowa, and came home to run the marathon, and she finished. Did great. Congratulations to her. I know a couple of people that ran it. So congrats to everybody that did that. I will never. I did a 5K once and like never doing that again. Thank you for asking.
What about a 0.3K? Would you do 0.3?
Oh, I would do that again. As long as there's donuts and coffee halfway through like there were last time.
Sure.
Yes, I would do that again, but that's my limit. Yeah, but I can't even, like, my brain can't process that. And as someone who has always dreaded running, like, to me, running is a punishment.
Oh yeah.
I can't, like, when I see the map, like, we were tracking Meg as she was running. I'm like, wow, look where she is. Like, she's in Uptown. And then we check in like an hour later, like, oh, she's, you know, parallel to Grand Park, but out west. Now, oh, now she's at like Pilsen. Like, what? Like, no, that is so much ground cover, dude.
It really is.
And how do you run? And you're like, okay, because this is how my brain works in this way, where even in life, my life is a series of goals.
Yeah.
So like, get me to, we talked about this, Jill's wedding. Get me to Disney. Get me to my cousin Nick's wedding. Get me to now Denver, which I'm leaving for on Tuesday. After that, get me to Tony's wedding.
Yeah.
Right. So it's like, I look through life in a series of things to get to. And if it's something miserable like that, like running, I'm constantly wondering how long it is till I'm done.
Yes.
And running 26 miles, how do you, like, I would love to know how you get in the headspace of being able to do that.
Right. And also the thing is too, running has its health benefits for people. You know what doesn't? Running marathons.
Yeah.
Like that's one of those where it's like you want to accomplish it, but you know it's legit and not even like a bit. Like, it is legitimately bad for your body to run marathons.
Yeah. It's like the fat version of eating the 96-ounce steak.
Yeah.
It's not good for you, but it's an achievement.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. Well, anyway, if you could do that, good for you. Congrats. I cannot, like, my brain cannot process such an achievement.
No.
So, like, and it's incredible.
You know how much of a bum I felt like getting into work and being like the literally the score is broadcasting the marathon, and I walk in sweaty because I had to walk from Ogilvy.
Rick, if you're on a marathon, you could say that.
Yeah, I ran my marathon, which was how long was it? Like 1.1 miles.
Oh, Rick, you're brave. You need to get a sticker for your car.
Yeah.
To let everybody know you did that.
No, I'd prefer the 0.0. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it is great, isn't it?
I love that it was represented too at the marathon.
Was it?
Yes.
I didn't see that.
Hold on, let me see if I can find the someone tweeted that they were wearing their 0.0 shirt at the marathon.
Those are our people.
Is incredible.
That's awesome.
Our guy Adam Cumbie. At the
is it on the I'm Fat podcast page? Let me see if I can.
It is. It's retweeted from the I'm Fat podcast page.
Beautiful. All right. I'm going to find it and we're going to try the screen sharing.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. All right. If you're watching on YouTube, I'm going to try this live. We'll do it live. Share screen window.
Oh, to the wall.
Why is it not doing it? See, I'm not doing it right. I don't know what's wrong.
Did you?
Oh, there we go. There. Oh no, I know what's wrong. Hold on. This
are you
is
not
riveting.
In Chrome?
I am in Chrome, but I'm on a, it's a, no one cares. I have to open it in a new window because the window I have open is what we have StreamYard in.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there you go. All
you
right, now.
Do it by tab.
Theoretically, this should work. You know what? I don't know what I'm doing. We'll just paste it into the podcast. All right.
Leave old man attempts technology.
Really, it is bad. Oh, here. I figured it out. Thank you, Rick. You're right.
Yeah.
Okay. Share. Is that working?
Yeah, it worked.
All right, great. There you go. Thanks, Adam, for wearing the 0.0 shirt. Looks good in blue.
It does.
Why does he have a loofah?
No idea.
Yeah, okay, I don't know. These are questions maybe we shouldn't ask.
Probably a good call because, post-marathon things are gross. The first time I saw the calcium deposits on somebody's shirt, I'm like, it's...
Ew.
Yeah.
I always think of Andy in the office with his bleeding nipples. Yeah. All right. One more thing before Ask a Fats.
Okay.
I tried something this week. Finally found the Little Debbie's Swiss Cake Roll ice cream.
Oh, yeah.
Gotta say, a little bit disappointed. It was chocolate ice cream, which I get that a Swiss cake roll is chocolate, but chocolate ice cream is a really dominant flavor.
Yeah.
And it kind of took away. So I think just to all companies, if you're doing this thing flavored ice cream, the base of the ice cream should be like a cream or a vanilla.
Yes.
And then you add in and you just take whatever it is and you just mix it in. Right. I was hoping it would be like vanilla or whatever they want to call it, birthday cake or whatever ice cream with Swiss cake rolls literally blended into it. That would have been perfect.
Yes.
Instead, this was chocolate ice cream with like a little bit of cake and white frosting in it. But it could have been better. I was a little bit disappointed. But it wasn't bad. Like, I would have it again. And it was
but
like
you wouldn't necessarily choose it.
I would not choose it. Right.
Yeah.
That's correct.
Okay. All right.
Is it time to ask the fats?
Oh, it is.
Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. It's been 1 week since my last confession.
Okay, my son. What is your confession?
I'm fat.
Ask a Fat is brought to you by our buddy, Charlie the Bacon Guy. Little bit of a special until November 1st. With every order you place with Charlie, you will get a free original bacon jam. Yeah. Here's Charlie. Yes, sir. With this week's bacon report.
Thanks, Jay. This week we have maple pepper and chorizo bacon. And the newest flavor is going to be a sampler packet. Four different bacon flavors, still weighing about a pound, and those will still be $12. We'll sell them at the end of October and through November and December for your holiday orders, which you should get your pre-orders in for that. The flavors for the sampler will be varying, but probably some maple pepper, definitely chorizo, maybe some rosemary, maybe some buffalo, maybe some ranch, who knows. That is undecided yet. bacon jams. We have the original, the bourbon, and the chile rojo. And as always, we have all the merchandise that we usually mention. The order is in for the new winter hats, so get those on your order for the holiday season. For the Bacon Report, I'm Charlie the Bacon Guy.
$12 a pound for Charlie the Bacon Guy's bacon. For reference, as I was listening to the Bacon Report, a pound of Oscar Mayer bacon, which is your basic, cheapest you can buy, $8.99. So for basically $3 more, not only are you supporting a small business, a local small business like Charlie's, you're getting craft freaking homemade bacon that is absolutely incredible. Do it. Send him an email, charliethebaconguy@gmail.com. You can hit him up on Instagram at charliethebaconguy or on Twitter at czthebaconguy. Do it. Get those orders in for the holidays. They freeze up beautifully. And also, Charlie needs to get ahead of it. That's why he's encouraging you to place that order by November 1st. He'll take more after that, but he needs to make a plan. So get in touch. You place an order before November 1st. That gives you almost the whole rest, until it gives you the rest of this month, of course, to get that order in. You get a free bacon jam. Boom. Beautiful. So any incentive you needed to order, now you've got it. Get some bacon from Charlie. You will not regret it. It's absolutely fantastic. CharlieTheBaconGuy@gmail.com is the easiest and best way to do that. All right, we've got no voicemails today. If you'd like to leave us one for next week, please do. 708-858-3314. We'll get to these emails at imfatpod@gmail.com. And I know that even though we don't have voicemails, people love to hear the song. So I gotta play the song from Russ.
Ask a fat about this and that. It's time to chat with the fats.
All right, Rick, why don't you tackle I'll do the first one. I don't mind doing it. Well, this is basically, we've told everybody about Fredo's, right?
Yeah.
And how much we love Fredo's. And I'm saving this email actually as the read because it's so wonderful. So, Rick, it's all you, buddy. Go ahead.
This is from Nolan. So Nolan sends us, hey guys, if you read this on the pod, you'll probably have to leave out the details of this just due to not wanting to have Fredo's. Wait, what?
No. It's okay.
Oh, okay.
It's okay.
I was like, wait a minute. That starts out ominously. No. The details is just due to not wanting to have Fredo's lose money due to their generosity, and I don't want people to take that for granted. I probably should have read a little further. But my best friend, son, and I went to Fredo's for an epic meal for my bachelor party day. We live in LaPorte, Indiana, so it was quite a drive to get there. But since being our first time and the last hurrah before I ruined my life for the second time, second marriage. That's the spirit.
Come on.
So back in July, we arrived at Fredo's around 1 PM. The gentleman taking our orders was amazing, personable and helpful and looking over the menu, but I'm fat and already had done that like 10 times leading up to that day. A man after my heart.
Yep.
But since it was a celebration and a trip, we probably won't make out as often as we would all like to. My son didn't want to stray from his staple cheeseburger and fries, but my friend and I went all out and extra fat. Nice. To share, we ordered the I'm Fat Burger, mozzarella sticks, which on a cold day could make a guy self-conscious, and a large adult mac and cheese pizza. Holy sweet baby Jesus. All was phenomenal, of course. A few workers came and socialized with us and couldn't have been more amazing. Here's where they go above and beyond. I was on a restaurant review page for Valparaiso, Indiana. A guy was giving a review of a new age hip style taco place in Valpo. It's called Ricochet, in parentheses. If you get the chance, seriously check it out. Pastrami on a taco. Enough said.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Anyway, he said he had some friend that drove from Indy just to go there. So I commented, if you're willing to travel for some incredible food, head to Schaumburg and go to Fredo's and tag them. They see the comment and also comment, thank you very much, and please message us. So I message them, and they say, we sincerely appreciate the kind words and sharing their name and promoting them. Would you send us your phone number, and we'll put some money into your account for the next time you dine with us? So I shared my information with them, and they messaged back, next time you come in, just give us your number, and you have $40 on your account. I was blown away. $5 to $10 usually is what I'd expect, but $40? Absolutely amazing. So I apologize for the long-winded story, but just had to share.
No, that is so on brand for Fredo's. It really is. Like, they are not just like your run-of-the-mill place. It is a special place. And you walk in there and you know it's different.
Yep.
And the way you're treated, the way the menu is, everything there is spectacular. It's only going to get better. Big news to share coming soon. But yeah, that is a very typical Frato story.
Yes.
Like when we got the catering, there was so much pasta salad. We're like, do we order all this right now? We just made a bunch. So we gave you some extra, you know, so everybody got to take home like a whole bunch of pasta salad. They just go above and beyond, yep. You know, it's what I was talking about, you know, earlier with Buona, like that stuff matters in this day and age, right? Like go the extra mile, take the extra step. Frato's is fantastic at that. They appreciate people appreciating them because honestly, owning a business is tough, you know, running a restaurant like that in this day and age is really, really difficult. So when people go out of their way to promote and let other people know about it, they're so appreciative and they're happy to give you that to have you come back in. Now, again, it's probably not typical. Not everybody that tags Frato's is going to get $40, but like just those random acts of kindness, it totally tracks with what Michael and everybody down at Frato's are doing. So it does not surprise me in the least. It's an awesome story. I'm glad you enjoyed it, and I'm glad you are going to go back now because you have incentive to. So that's great. And yes, those mozzarella sticks will make you feel shame as a man because they are large and girthy. All right, got one here from Spike. Spike, I appreciate the level of respect you're giving us on this email, but I think you're probably giving us – you're reaching out to the wrong person. So, Charlie, if you're listening, listen in and respond, and we'll send this over to Spike. He says, I made a chicken and sausage gumbo over the weekend. It was my first time making it. I was worried that I would screw up the roux. In the recipe on YouTube that I followed, the cook got the roux to a nice chocolate-like consistency. Mine was more like peanut butter. It wasn't getting any darker, so I just moved on. Any suggestions? Charlie, this is where you come in.
Yeah.
He needs a thinner gumbo. The gumbo still came out great, but it was more of a... Oh, thicker. I'm sorry. It was more of a soup than a stew. Still tasty. I'm going to try jambalaya next. Chuck's Cafe in Burbank does a kick-ass jambalaya. Yes, they do. With chicken, though. Yes, the Chuck's jambalaya is fantastic. That's from Spike. Spike, I can't help you. I'm not that good of a cook. I would like to be, but I'm not, and I probably never will be. But it is it's a skill, and I would reach out to Charlie, even talk to Charlie on Twitter, at CZ the Bacon Guy, and Charlie listens every episode, so I'm sure he'll get in touch, and I can forward you his suggestion, but I don't know, but it sounds great.
Yeah.
It sounds great. Yeah.
It really does. Oh, Jay, I will share one detail of said person that I went on said date with.
Yes.
She cooks.
Oh, no. That's bad for her and good for you. Like, please refill my trough. Or the first meal she'll cook, she'll be like, what are you gonna have?
Right.
Yeah. No, that's great.
Oh god, yeah. So
that's awesome. That's so good, man. I'm legit so happy. Like I'm chomping at the bit. Like, I want to meet her, I want to hang out.
Why are you turning into Parkins?
I want to hang out with her, talk to her about sports, 24/7. No, won't be doing that.
We won't be doing
that. Did I send you thirst trap Parkins photo?
Yes, you did. I lost it. It was so funny.
All right. This will be a little treat for the people that hang out with us the entire show. Yeah, I'll share this photo.
Yeah, a couple nuggets here at the end.
Give me a second. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. It's going to take a second because I got to airdrop it to myself.
Oh, and then let
that little beep go through.
Oh, yeah, that's true. I didn't hear it.
Okay. All right. Screen share time. Just give me a second while I figure this out again.
Okay.
I got to move the whole window over. Okay. Thirst trap Parkins. Oh, God. Apparently, it was date night for Danny and Steph. And there it is. I can't. Dude. I said it to Shane. I said, I don't know what it is, but please do something with this picture. And it's like, he's just, and for those that know Danny, he's probably not the most romantic guy in the world, but I don't know if he was intentionally posing for this photo or not,
I feel like he might have been, and it's like this is a lack of game, recognized lack of game situation. So believe me, like, I am not speaking about anything of myself. Of just like, if someone said, "Hey, try and pose in a DC, like a you know, any try and pose period," I'd be like, I don't know what to do. But I don't know what to do with my hands. Like, that'd be me. Yes. So, but it's really funny.
It's funny. And look, I'm the same way. I'm not the, like, Hope, because I tried on two new pairs of glasses yesterday, and Hope's like, "All right, take a picture and I'll send it to our friends." I'm like, I don't know how to look when I take a picture. I was like,
yeah.
You ever see, I know you've seen it, the video of the kids who like go through the line dabbing.
Yeah, they're, yes.
And then the white kid comes up at the end, he goes, and the teacher goes, "Lord have mercy. That's me posing for any photo." I just don't know how to do it. So the thing I know how to do is smile big. Mm-hmm. Like, I can big family pictures. Like, I'll look good in those, 'cause I'm just smiling really big and I don't talk. But if it's like a picture of just me.
Yeah.
My friend Dre took headshots of me once. She's like, "What is wrong with you?" I go, "I don't know what to do.
Right.
Am I supposed to smile? Am I supposed to look happy? Right. I don't know how to do this. I'm sorry."
I hope I'm never in a position to have to like take those types of pictures. I mean, okay, he'd get some headshots and whatever. I'd be like, just like awkward smirk. Yeah.
No, that's why I was like, I don't know how to smile. I don't know how to do this. Yeah. And then I got my Blackhawks credential.
Okay.
My first ever full season credential for any team.
Nice.
And Kalia, who's the PR girl with the Hawks, is like, "Oh, I picked out the pictures this year, so I just found whatever I found." And I'd never seen this picture myself. Apparently, it's like an outtake from the Odyssey photo shoot, and I'm doing like sassy. I'm like arms folded. And like looking at like, "Why'd you pick out the sassy picture of me?" She's like, "I don't know. It just thought it was a good picture." I go,
"Okay.
I appreciate the effort."
Okay. Yeah.
But I didn't think you'd get Sassy Jay on the credential.
Sassy Jay. That's.
I'll see if I can find the photo for next week and maybe I can share it. I can't share the credential.
No. You're not allowed. Yeah.
I'll see if I can find the photo for next week. But
that's fantastic.
All right, let's wrap this up. I got Wingstop waiting upstairs.
Yeah, I am running on empty. I'm going to sleep at some point.
Do it.
At I'm Fat Pod on social media. See, I can't. I'm not even doing this right. All of our social media at I'm Fat Pod, I'mFatPod@gmail.com. Patreon, TeePublic. There's not a sale at this very moment. Wait about five this very moments, and you'll have a sale from TeePublic. YouTube.com/I'mFatPodcast. Subscribe, unsubscribe, resubscribe, all that crap. Rate and review the podcast. Do all of it and check out our sponsors. Charlie the Bacon Guy, Mazda of Orland Park, Fredo's Culinary Kitchen, and Wednesday, Herder Burger is back. Let's go.
Yes. By the way, we do have sale dates for TeePublic. I pulled these up. October 12th through 16th, October 20th through 21st, and October 26th through 30th.
Okay.
So that's
after
it.
After you get some grease on the 12th, when you get some grease on your shirt from the Curter Burger, then go on TeePublic, take advantage of the sale, and get yourself a new shirt and some other merch.
Okay? I wrap it up. The music's running out.
Okay. For Jay, I'm Rick. This is that podcast. Damn it.
I hope you have a contastic day.
We tried.